quite weak across all categories. Kevin Deesa, the CFO of the company, joins us on the phone line to talk about that. Kevin, hi, good morning. It's been a dismal performance across all segments. Total sales down 9%, exports down 19%, and domestic sales are also down 1.5%. What's the expectation for the festive months?
Sonia, I'd like to just put it across in a slightly different perspective. You see, don't compare quarter on quarter because of the shift that is really taking place in the festive season. So let's look at November numbers that we did last year was about 127,000 numbers. And this year, this month, my estimate will be at least about 160,000 numbers purely on account of the shift of the festive season. So if you look at both put together, when you look at October and November, I don't think the number that you're mentioning is dismal is really going to be dismal. That's point number one. Point number two.
No, I'm talking just about the October sales that you've reported this month versus same time last year. Okay, I take your point that the festive season has changed, etc. But, you know, when we had that discussion with Ravi Kumar last month, he indicated that despite the festive season being here and there, he will still be able to report a growth in most segments, which has not come through this month around. So the question I'm asking is, have you seen any, when do you expect to see a sustainable revival in growth?
From November onwards, purely on account of the basis of last year's base effect.
Okay.
Now, secondly, let me also give a little bit of flair to the numbers that we are talking about. You see, in CT and the Platina, where most of the analysts and most of the fund managers felt that it is only the vehicles that will sell during the festive, during the marriage markets, in the festive season, they had thought that it would not sell, but we had done over 100,000 numbers of Platina CT 100 in this month.
Okay.
The second is the Pulsar, which has crossed 71,000 numbers in this month. But most encouraging is the Avenger.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as you know, we just launched the Avenger. And as a CFO, as a president of finance, I was very, let me say, conservative. And my thought was from a selling of about 3,000 numbers, we would do about 15,000 numbers at the most of Avenger. But the number of messages that I'm getting across from the dealers is one single message. That is FLG with two exclamation marks. That is basically what they're saying is feel like God. And this is a sale that is taking place in Avenger. This month, though we started the Avenger sale just about 10, 15 days back, we have already built 7,000 numbers and the bookings are overflowing over there.
Okay.
So for me, it's not just the number that I'm talking about, but the mix and the potential of the numbers going forward. Same is the situation in the Pulsar. The RS200 is rocking.
Okay, in that case, Kevin, well, first, good morning. You know, how would you rate the second half then? You know, whereas the motorcycle sales have been around, 3.1, 3.2 in the first half, more like 3.1. In the second half, would you say the monthly run rate would be what, 3.3?
The monthly run rate, let me break it up into domestic and exports, Lata. As far as the domestic is concerned, I would say the run rate should be somewhere near 1.7.
Okay.
The reason why I'm mentioning about this is, A, there is the Avenger that's coming in. Like I said, I believe the run rate could be somewhere near about 20,000 numbers now, as against an average of 3,000 numbers. That's one part. The second part is an all-new vehicle, a new brand coming up in February and March, which will give us incremental numbers. So on an average, for the next 6 months, including the month that is just over, I would say a run rate in the domestic of 1.7 to 1.8 is very much possible.
Okay.
Coming to the export, I'll touch upon exports again.
Please.
I would rather like all of you all to look at exports on a longer term potential rather than month on month for two reasons. In the first reason is when it comes to a domestic sale, all I have to do is get the cash, dispatch the vehicle, transaction over. Less cash, I send off in by way of a credit, transaction over. In the case of export, I require a letter of credit in advance before I start production of the goods because each of the products are specific to that country. Secondly, is the shipping that takes place. So there will always be some sort of a distortion in the numbers if you take on a month-on-month basis. But if you take a quarter, if you take an annual basis, I'm on track for the 2 million numbers. This month, for example, it is slightly low, again, because the focus has been on the domestic market. And I would say that even next month, I don't see any significant growth in the export numbers purely on account of the fact that I'll be focusing on the domestic sales. My colleague Rakesh Sharma, who's head of motorcycles, in the first quarter sold 64,000 Pulsars. in the second quarter, he sold 97,000 Pulsars. But today, he's not in a position to get the Pulsars and the Avengers purely because of the domestic market.
Okay. So, Kevin, for exports, you did about 1.27 lakh this month.
That's
in
right.
November and December, what could the run rate be?
I would say that November would be somewhere near 1.35 or so.
Okay.
But December onwards, I would say it could be closer to about 1.5 or so.
Okay. And can you give us a breakup of the markets, Sri Lanka, Nigeria, Egypt? What have you done this month? And have you seen any improving trends?
We don't share on a month-on-month basis. But I will grant this thing that in this month, I did lose a little bit of sale to Nepal.
Okay.
This is because of the dispute and the slight conflict, if I may say so, between India and Nepal on the various constitution amendment. Mm-hmm. So there is a bit of a disturbance in the trade over there.
Okay. Then let me, since you say you're selling more high-value bikes and that,
yes.
and therefore the volume numbers don't reflect it, what would you say in terms of second half revenues? You've done what a little shy of 6,000 crores in the second quarter.
Correct.
Should we expect in the third and the fourth quarters this to be 20% higher, 10% higher?
I won't give a 20%, but I would say a 8 to 10% growth higher than the third quarter. Certainly, second quarter will be certainly there.
Okay, and margins?
Margins I won't comment on, but like I said, at the start of the year, I was always talking in terms of a 20% margin on the whole year basis. First quarter, we did 21.4 or so. Second quarter, we did 22. I would say for the second half, commodity prices are stable. The exchange rate is by and large fixed. We have got ourselves hedged to that extent. The higher products prices that are coming in, the mix that is taking place, I would say for the second half, a margin of 21 to between 21 to 22 seems to be okay.
Okay, you did mention CT100 and Platina is 100,000, which is very good compared to 91,000 that you sold last month.
That's
and
right.
Avengers also looking good. What did you do with the new Discover? You sold about 17,000 in September. So
the
how many did
Discovers
you
sell? The total Discovers we sold this month is around 25,000 numbers.
Okay.
I expect the Discover, based on the history, etc., would be stable at this level, which would be good for us because we'll have to build it up over a period. But we are looking very clearly at the new brand that will be coming out in February, March, which I believe will be a major shift in the customer, in the industry sales.
Okay. And overall, the sales on 3.5 lakhs, which is the base, what do you expect for November and December?
I would say that November and December would be November would be almost the same. As I explained to you, festive season is for November. We should be having some good numbers. Exports will be remaining the same. And in December, with the numbers of domestic coming up, but exports will grow.
All right. Okay, Kevin, we leave it at that. Thanks for joining us. So that's the word coming in from Bajaj Auto. The important takeaway is at 3.5 lakhs that they are sitting this month, which is a drop of 9%. They don't see any improvement in November. They expect 3.5 lakhs itself in the month of November. So month on month, don't expect any major growth. And I think that's the reason the stock as well is down almost about 3% or so. Okay, that's Coffee Day settles at 317 rupees a share in pre-opening versus its issue price of 328 rupees a share. So it would be interesting to see the opening for this one. We take a break, but more on the Coffee Day listing. It makes its debut on the exchanges in just a few minutes from now. We'll track that on the other side.